71% of Earth's surface is covered by oceans' salt water, and the remaining area of Earth contains continents and islands. Certain natural resources are abundant in particular areas of the world by nature. These resources should be made available throughout the world. International trade is the exchange of goods and services across national borders. The main route of international trading was to maritime trade, which served as a dependable network for long-distance trade and increasingly prominent during the Middle Age. The Silk Route was one of the first trade routes to join the Eastern and the Western world. Mariners were able to identify the routes during daytime. During the night, they used to burn coal or heaps of wood in the high pinnacles of rocks or mountains flanking the coastline. This has been the foundation for inventing lighthouses. Pharos of Alexandria was the world's first lighthouse and was built in the 3rd century. It was said to be 135 meters high. During the night, flames of fire were burner, which was visible from a distance of 20 miles. In sea, smoke emanating from fire enabled the tower to serve as a landmark. In the 13th century, this lighthouse got damaged due to a severe earthquake. As time advanced, the trading also increased between the nations. The number of vessels on voyage also increased. If there were no effective aids to navigate, there might be many unexpected mishaps. To avoid the wreckage and facilitate safe navigation and perfect berthing at all places, navigation aids played an important role. Indian Peninsula has 7,517 kilometers coastline dotted with lighthouses and other aids to navigation. Presently, all A2N are maintained by the Directorate General of Lighthouses and Lightships, Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways. In the year 1927, to set up a central authority for the administration, the legislation called the Indian Lighthouse Act was passed. It is now renamed as Lighthouse Act 1927. It is an act to consolidate and amend the law relating to the provision, maintenance and control of the lighthouses by the Government of India. The present inventory of the Directorate has 410 aids to navigation. There are 195 lighthouses, 23 DGNSS stations, 64 radar beacons, 21 deep-sea lighted buoys, 4 wreck marking buoys, 1 lightship, 10 virtual aids to navigation, 87 AIS physical shore station PSS, and 6 AIS-based station in VTS GOK. It may be surprising to know that DGLL is maintaining 195 lighthouses. They not only serve the mariners, but they also fulfill the country's social commitment by serving fishing communities who solely depend on the lighthouses. The Directorate maintains deep water channels in depth, varying between 25 and 40 meters, by marking them with lighted buoys. There are a total of 21 buoys in the Gulf of Kutch and Gulf of Khambat. Buoys marking the Salaya navigable channels. There are 11 deep water marking buoys in the Gulf of Kutch. In the Gulf of Khambat, 9 buoys guide the vessel to navigate them. DGLL also have a buoy tender vessel. Indira Point provides his services in the maritime sector of India. There are 3 steps in the maintenance of buoys: retrieving, repairing, and relaying of buoys. A buoy yard is an open place where buoy material are stored for a short period. DGLL is maintaining a buoy yard at Okha in Gujarat. DGPS, Differential Global Positioning System. DGPS is a widely used radio aid in India. It is an enhanced global positioning system. DGLL has a chain of 23 new GPS stations along the Indian coast, including Andaman Nicobar and Lakshadweep Islands, providing better than 5-meter accuracy in an economic exclusive zone of Indian waters. Radar beacons are user-friendly to mariners. It works when interrogated with a signal from the ship radar in the vicinity and provides range and direction of the ship concerning the radar beacon's position. There is a chain of 64 radar placed along the Indian coastline. Vessel traffic service is established for organizing traffic and minimizing risk and protecting environmental disasters. The major ports along the coastline of India are equipped with vessel service setup. VTS established in Gulf of Kutch to facilitate the safe movement of vessels. Master Control Center is set up in Kandla. The system has 9X band radar sensors strategically located. Total, there are 22 sites spread along the coast of 800 kilometers and are covering a water area of 16,500 square kilometers. Area-wise, the VTS Gulf of Kutch is one of the largest such systems in the world managed by DGLL. For effective management of aids to navigate and monitoring of vessels with AIS on board, DGLL has established a National Automatic Identification System network with 87 Physical Shore Station (PSS) and National Data Center at Mumbai. Virtual ATON are provided where it is not practically possible to install a physical aid to navigation. DGLL has also established safety information and weather-related message network. Navtex chain consists of 7 Navtex transmitting stations along the entire Indian coastline in Nav Area 8. In order to maintain and upgrade the knowledge in the field of A2N, Directorate General of Lighthouses and Lightships has also established a Marine Navigation Training Institute, MNTI, to cater for the training needs on aids to marine navigation and VTS by organizing various courses designed in accordance with the IALA Worldwide Academy. India has been nominated as single point contact by IALA for capacity building on ATONs. Training needs for North Indian Ocean Rim (NIOR) countries and littoral countries, Indonesia, Singapore and Malaysia. DGLL contributes the nation towards the reduction of carbon emission by providing renewable source of energy to all lighthouses along the Indian coast. Our motto is to provide safe and secure navigation in the Indian waters.